Day into all. Let's continue our chapter training in sports. Already we learned strength and endurance. Today we are going to study about speed. Speed is plays a vital role in the almost all the games and sports. Speed is the ability to do the movements one place to another shortest possible time. That means an individual has to perform a movement in the shortest period of and possible velocity. For example, the movement of smashes am in the volleyball. Speed is the product of genetic and environmental factors. An individual has, there are two types of muscle fibers. They are red muscle fibers and white muscle fibers. Red muscle fibers are also known as slow-twitch muscle fibers, and white muscle fibers are known as fast-twitch muscle fibers. An individual has more percentage of white muscle fibers will be faster movement, whereas slow-twitch or red muscle fibers are more will have stamina or endurance. The percentage of muscle fibers movement can be changed. Same time, environmental changes can be changed. Subtopic is types of speed. There are five types of speed. One is reaction ability, second one is acceleration ability, third one is movement speed, fourth one is locomotor ability, and fifth one is speed endurance. In that, first one is reaction abilities. It is mainly depend upon the central nervous system. It is one of the coordinative abilities. Reaction abilities, the ability to react effectively and quickly to signal or action. Reaction abilities mainly classified into two types, simple reaction ability and complex reaction ability. First one is simple reaction ability. Simple reaction ability is the ability to react effectively and quickly to non-signal or predicted signal. For example, an athlete sitting in a crouch position or sitting start position for 100 meter race already then knows the signal, either gun sound or whistle sound. It's a predicted one. Okay. Second one is complex reaction ability. Complex reaction ability is ability to react effectively and quickly to unknown sound or unknown actions. It's a unpredictable one. For example, a batsman face a ball in cricket. Third one is acceleration ability. It is the ability to achieve maximum speed from the stationary position. It is mainly depends upon the techniques, flexibility, etc. Third one is movement speed. It is the ability to do the movements in minimum time. It is mainly depends upon the techniques, explosive strength, flexibility and coordinative abilities. Fourth one is locomotor ability. It is the ability to achieve maximum speed for maximum distance or time. Last one is speed endurance. It's the ability to perform movements with a high speed under condition of fatigue. It's mainly depends upon the central nervous system, techniques, explosive strength and speed. It's a combination of strength and speed. These are all about types of speed. Next subtopic is methods to develop speed. There are two types. One is acceleration run method and second one is pace run method. In that, first one is acceleration run method. Acceleration run method means to attaining maximum speed from the stationary position or initial position. It should be kept in mind that the technique of any event it should be learned in the beginning. Then we should switch over to acceleration. For example, in 100 meter sprint race, we should lay stress on the technique of start and complete running action. We should practice at low speed. After learning the proper technique, we should practice that technique at higher speed. after completion of complete technique we should switch over to acceleration runs. Sprinters usually achieve their maximum speed from 6 seconds from the stationary position. Okay, if we want to improve their speed we have to do proper practice, that is proper repetition. This repetition works may be according to the age, experience of an athlete. It depends upon the capacity of an athlete. Repetitions may vary from 6 to 12. Second method is pace run method. Pace run method means running in a whole distance in a constant speed. This method is covered in a constant speed. For example, 800 meter race and above races. An athlete of 800 meter runner, his best time is 1 minute 40 seconds. In that 800 meter means there are 2 laps. In that first lap is covered in 49 seconds and the second lap is covered in 51 seconds. This procedure is known as pace run method. We should distribute our energy according to the distance. That means we should keep pace should be kept in mind. Okay, this method we should do practice thoroughly. That means each repetition work, after completing each repetition workout, we should give proper recovery period. After completing the recovery period, again second repetition should start. According to the talent of an individual, it should be increased the load. Okay, this is the method of pace run method. It's all about the methods of improving speed.